So now that we are nearly ready, we're not gonna make so much more noise. I wanted to invite Armando Bayolo to talk a little bit about the next piece, please. So come on in.
She was talking about earlier. I am not actually a living composer. I just checked it. Really, seriously, somebody call a doctor, please. So not that kind of doctor. Oh. I'm a mad doctor. I must be because I wrote a 3-hour-long chamber piece. Los Caprichos is a piece in 80 movements. And you will hear every single one of them. It makes a great middle for a program. No, what you'll hear is a selection. I can't remember how many we picked off the top of my head, but you have the a little insert with some reproductions of some thumbnails of the sketches that we'll see tonight, and with a translation of my own of the explanations that Goya himself had on his own manuscript copy of Los Caprichos, which is currently at the Prado Museum in Madrid. So it's known as the Prado manuscript. My interest in this piece and why I would write an 80 movement, 3-hour chamber piece, it began about 10 years ago or so with a piece simply called Caprichos, no definite article. That was commissioned by a group in Amsterdam called Hexna, that consists of piano, flutes. The director there is also a flutist, and but plays. He specifically wanted to showcase his contrabass flute, so it's a part for flute, piccolo, and contrabass flute. Recorder player who also plays alto recorder, a piccolo recorder, and a contrabass recorder, a flugelhorn player who has electronics, and piano. So it's a really wild ensemble that would never get replicated again. And I like the idea of I'm always inspired by other forms of art, and the idea of these sketches, as you'll see, are quite unusual. They're, to me, very ahead of their time. They're almost like they're proto-surrealism, but also proto, editorial cartooning, if you know the history of them. There's a little bit about it in the program notes, but you know, Goya kind of emerged from this illness in 1799. His job was to be the portrait artist for the King of Spain. But he, after this long illness, came out having read all this radical French philosophy and came out with this book that criticized Spanish mores and all the ills in society that he was seeing, and occasionally, like, you know, names the king's wife who he was having an affair with, or, you know, oh, there's this other guy who's you know, his chamberlain who is robbing people or something like that. And so and he's criticizing, one of the forces that he criticizes the most is also the state and the religious authorities. So he got in trouble with the Inquisition. And ironically, it was the King of Spain who saved him from the Inquisition by purchasing the entire run of the book and pardoning him. So it's kind of ironic, really, that you're criticizing someone who then, like, you're not so bad. So, but the idea of it, I really liked the kind of the quality of the things. And when it came time to do it with my ensemble, I arranged it for this configuration in those first 8 movements, and you'll hear at least 2 of them tonight, 3 of them. The very first one, El Sueño de la Razón, or The Dream of Reason, and the very last one are from that original set. I arranged them for my band for my 40th birthday concert just years ago, and then we presented them at the Bang in a Can Festival the following year, and the managing director of Great Noise and I, who are great friends, and she's also the clarinetist, but her job is to keep me from being too crazy. we were talking at Bang on Your Can. He's like, yeah, I have this crazy idea of, you know, like this lifetime project of when I have time, as little studies for myself to set all 80 of these things and maybe collect them in suites that people can do like we're going to do tonight. At one point, a theater company got involved and they were like trying to create a pantomime around the whole thing and you know, but then it could be performed in many different ways or, you know, do the whole thing and develop a menu and have a meal while you're based on the piece while you're having, so all these different ideas. And she said, yeah, that's a great idea. You should do that. And so I'm like, huh, if she says that's a great idea, I should do it, because she would say it's totally impractical and you know, what are you, crazy? So anyway, I've spoken too long. You'll hear, you know, the piece is also, you know, taking that idea of commenting on society in 1799. We're still dealing with a lot of the same issues. So the piece is also a commentary on that. But I'm also a bit of a sarcastic troll. So you will hear a lot of very, what I hope is very funny music in it. Tonight, there are not that many quotes. There's a lot of quotes in the entire piece. Goya himself is quoting in his etchings lots of different symbols and lots of different myths and things like that. So I quote lots of different music associated with it. I don't think we have any quotes. We have one that's really deeply buried from The Empire Strikes Back. No, I'm not kidding. But you won't be able to tell. Anyway, I'll leave it to Orlando. I hope you enjoy it. And so here is a little suite from Los Caprichos.